The moment we have been waiting for has finally arrived. The final hole. One drive and tight short game is all that separates our two budding robot golf finalists from $50,000 and a spot on the inaugural Robot Golf Tour Invitational. Ernie, you're a hole away from potential golf stardom. What's going on through your mind right now?
Oh, well, I'm just a used vehicle salesman who wants to play golf in a big robot. It's a real pleasure just to make it this far.
Ah, yes, wonderful, excellent. And Camilla, you brought your own style to the game, the King's Game 100-foot robot golf. If you win, do you think you're ready to compete in the big league alongside such fantabulous people such as Vani and myself?
Oh my goodness, thank you, Max, and thank you to the whole Yes, Let's Drive for Par family. Today, I stand here fixing to golf for the chance to prove myself as a robot golfer. What started in my heart as a 5-year-old cabbage hitter has grown into a burning desire to take the fairways and represent robot golfing at the highest level.
I don't think any of us saw where Max's TV show would end up. I don't think Max knew either. I mean, the Eagle incident pretty much ruined any chance of a second season. Yet he tried constantly to beat this dead horse long.
Max, I need you to take a break from beating yourself up and get ready for the Tour Association board meeting.
What's the point? They're just going to yell at us again for blowing up the moon that one time. If only I still had my show, then I'd at least be able to distract them with some tickets.
Wait, what did you just say?
Just that you blow up the moon once, and suddenly, you're the world's greatest villain.
No, the other thing.
Oh, just that if I still had the show, I could at least dazzle them with my superstar charm.
Huh. If we had a distraction, that'd make it easy for me to finally activate the Megapar and...
What's that, my partner in putting?
Max, listen very carefully. I need you to do something. I need you...
to get the show.
To get the show?
Collectible plates from eBay.
Back together to do a reunion show.
A reunion show? Yes. Yes, of course. Bring together the best robot golf stars in the world to make me popular again.
To celebrate robot golf.
And to celebrate robot golf.
On the moon, on the site of the Eagle incident, if you assemble your stars, I'll provide you with the show of the century.
And I know exactly where to start.
Welcome to this year's Drive to Rebuild Charity Robot Golf Tournament. Up to the tee now is Camilla. For the young ones out there, she was on television for a short while, back before the robots ate all of our televisions for energy.
That building spends its free time helping the less fortunate. Don't you feel bad now?
Oh, hello there, Camilla.
Max, is that you? You're a sight for sore eyes. What brings you to this neck of the woods?
I have a proposal for you. How about we discuss it, over some golf?
That ball got some nasty bounce on it. Let's see if we can't get it off the concrete.
Oh no, Max is in the rough.
I hope destroying that building made you feel like a real big person. A chance to redeem themselves who are trying to get out of the rough.
You probably wanted the ball to go in the hole, and it didn't, and you beefed it.
Let's see if we can't scoop that bad boy right out of the office.
Beautiful shot from Max.
Are you rough enough? Let's find out.
Your Magnum Ball's ready.
It's hole o'clock. We're on the green.
Well, folks, as they say, it ain't easy being green.
Well, Kermit is dead, so I have to agree with that.
Woof. Those are some rough chuckles.
So, what's this proposal of yours?
Well, Bonnie and I have decided to...
I'm in.
But I haven't even told you.
Oh, you're putting together a special show about me, of course. I'm surprised it took you this long, but I'm absolutely on board. Oh, where are my manners? I'm flattered too, naturally.
Also, we'll be bringing some other contestants back too.
Let me think about this for a bit.
I'm not supposed to pick favorites, but I'm a big Max fan.
I guess you could call it Camilla. A golfer supreme. Featuring those who know her well.
Well, it'd be up to the network to decide.
Okay. How about Camilla and Friends?
Am I looking at Ryan Gosling? Because that was a great drive.
Now that building wasn't exactly in the way, but I'm glad I can get it. Looks like there's a bit of grass there that the groundskeeper forgot to mow. It happens to all of us. Let's see if we can't get our ball out of that little pesky hornet's nest. Somebody get Brendan Fraser from The Mummy out here, because we're on a sand adventure. Don't let me down, Max.
You just pitched that so good, it's like a baseball match in here. Hey, golf star, who's my good green boy? I can't believe it's not working. Great job.
Pick the title. Let's just get all the gang back together. It'll be fun.
Ah, yes, fantastic. I'm thinking the next recruit would be your final television sparring partner.
Ernie? He's never coming back to Robot Golf again. My charm and presence just couldn't be matched, and he went back to doing his,
successful used vehicle business?
That sounds right. You know what? I bet he'd love a Robot Golf makeover. Two great golfing celebrities like us.
Well, like me.
Bringing him in under our wings. Showing him the noble Robot Golf Tour lifestyle. Let's go get him. Do you know where he is?
I was hoping you'd have the number or...
Oh, gosh, no. I don't even know if my phone can dial that area code.
Jeeves, fetch me the address of Ernie.
Campaign!
Well, I just thought I'd never see you all again. Can I fetch you some iced tea or give you a tour of the latest rideable climbers we've got in?
Ernie, my fine fellow. Let's cut to the chase. I'd like for you to be a part of my robot golf reunion show I'm putting on.
Featuring Camilla.
Ah, geez, Max, Camilla, I appreciate the offer, but I've got a pretty neat business going on here. Things are going well, but I don't know if their Ernie takes a robot golf vacation level.
Okay, fine. How much do you want around? 300? 2,000? 3,000?
Whew, well, dang, gosh, that's a lot of money here, but... I'm not doing this for the money. I just want to help people find the dream vehicle for climbing...
Fine. Max, let's go.
Wait, Ernie, how about this? Let's play a round of golf together. You never could resist, and it is your passion. For old time's sake? Who knows when you'll get the chance to robot golf again otherwise? I'll even loan you my robot, the Steel Horse.
Max, that's a mighty fine offer, but there's no need for that. Let me show you something.
I'm impressed. I didn't know you were a mechanic and a builder.
Well, it's just a little something I've been tinkering with. We do get a lot of unusable vehicles at the store, and it would be a shame to just throw them out.
It's very, brown. Rustic.
I was thinking of calling him Bullet William.
Oh, Rustic Rusty. Yes, what a great name. Camilla does it again.
We're all teed up and ready to go. That is, of course, not a regulation tee, but a human femur. Thanks, robots. Ernie, the huge swing. That ball is off to dreamland. Come to sleep on the fairway.
So concerned that if we could give robots area of effect weapons, but we didn't stop to think about if we should.
Yep, that's the shot right there.
You're a natural, Ernie. You don't need much practice at all. You're a natural.
Aw, shucks, Max. You're too kind.
It's in the sand. What a shame. That's gonna get everywhere in that 100-foot robot.
Looks like this shot's favorite actor from the old times is Adam Sandler. Let's see if we can't get out of this bunker.
not sure if it was supposed to be some kind of statement, but they did destroy that building. Ernie gets ready to golf.
All right, no one, Ryan, ready to pitch.
I expected better from Ernie. Now, Griffin, would you say that every grain of sand represents a child's dream?
I would say it actually represents a human life that was lost in the 100-foot robot war.
And Justin, how many loved ones would you say you lost in the robot war?
I'm no longer familiar with the concept of love. I washed it away with the memories of everyone I ever cared about.
Great, great. Yeah, let's see how this goes. Good, good driver, boy. That was excellent.
Now we're talking.
Are we?
Look in your heart, Ernie. The golf was in you all along.
Duck! Do you guys remember ducks?
Oh, dream putt.
Hey, Big Pro. Congratulations. You're on the green. Nice.
Oh, you already had it in. That was terrific.
Time to shake what your mama and the factory gave you. We're on to the next hole.
Folks, it's the moment you've all been waiting for. It's drive time.
If this were an autobiography of that shot's life story, we'd have reached the conclusion, the stirring ending for that shot.
No creation without destruction. Good job. Make me proud, Ernie.
Put a little too much power into the old submarine there.
Well, darling, that's what you get for using those old Fadics in your engine. That and your weird green-yellow hydraulic hybrid.
Whoa, dang, Camilla. I didn't know you knew your way around the inside of these old beasts.
That's what I overheard my mechanic talking about, and she's one of the best in the business that money can buy. Yep.
You pitched it good. Your mom and I are proud of you.
Now, you don't want to end up in the sand. There's a pretty good chance that you will upset the giant mutant hate crabs that live under the mantle of the earth, and that is the last thing you want if you're trying to keep it under par.
Supposed to pick favorites, but I'm a big Ernie fan. Sand, huh? Okay. Well, a rolling ball gathers no moss, but that's not going to be an issue here. And it looks like it's time for some Ernie golf.
You just look that so good, it's like a baseball match in here.
That ball is going. No, oh, no, wait, sorry, it stopped.
Shooting off an approach shot from the fairway, let's see if we can avoid the remnants of human civilization that seem to be in the way of this good shot. Now, I know the canyon looks like a giant golf hole, but try to keep it on the mountain next time. Who knew Ernie had it in him? That was terrific.
Better gird your servos. You're headed to the sand.
Now, Griffin, he's really golfing up a sandstorm here. What do you think he's trying to do?
Travis, they're just trying their best. I don't see any reason to get mean about it.
Okay, you really put me in my place. Back to the golf. The prophecy foretold that would this putt not be sunk, that I would die alone.
Let's get deep in the paint. And why is there so much paint out there? This is a golf course, and we're on to the next hole.
The first shot means infinite possibility. Could you shoot it towards the hole? Sure. Why not blast it into the clouds? Give them a little ball treat.
Now, Ernie, present yourself like a gentleman. Sit upright in your seat. Good posture in the cockpit means good swing on the course.
Oh, jeez. Camilla, I don't think it really matters how I sit my dang rear in the...
Back straight. Shoulders back. The rain in Spain mainly falls on the remains of Spain. We'll make you a distinguished robot golfer yet.
Pitch.
You know, when I was a kid, I used to make forts in the snow. Anyways, how's your day going? You pitched it good. Your mom and I are proud of you. Look at that lazy ball, just stopping wherever it wants.
Well, are you gonna wait for summer or what? Hit it. Smell that? It's time for a comeback.
Just like my first marriage, it looks like things have gotten a little rocky. They're teetering on the edge of defeat and the edge of that cliff. Let's see how they do.
Ooh, daddy like.
It looks like they're trying to make some sort of fat, wingless, armless, legless, headless snow angels or something.
Look in your heart, Ernie. The golf was in you all along.
This would probably be easier with a shovel, but you have a golf club.
Get to it.
Boy, that ball's got wings. Which means, of course, that this golfer will be disqualified. Winged balls are strictly against the rules.
Ernie's doing his best out there, and unfortunately that's just not enough. All right, no one, Ryan. Way to pitch. Time for this robot to tangle with its natural enemy, grass. You're headed to the green.
I don't think there's any grass on the
green. Yeah,
that's why it's called green.
Green? Yeah.
What?
Yes. Well, we finally made it to the green. My only question is, who'd even think of putting a tavern there?
Golfer, golf.
Okay, I'm still a little rusty, but I can't turn down a few rounds of robot golf. Count me in.
That's just peachy. Now, Max, who are you thinking of to round out the reunion tour?
Ah, yes. That's definitely going to have to be a surprise for you two. I want your reactions to be genuine when you see them.
Oh, I hope it's that young fella, you know, what is his name? The guy with the golf.
Now, Max, I swear, if you bring back Robert Boxman to this, I mean, I respect you, but I refuse to even acknowledge a round of golf with that...
Whoa there, now. Robert just needed a helping hand with his passion. No need to put him down because of his attire.
His attire? His attire is literally boxes. He's a grown, 6-foot gentleman wearing a box, pretending to partake in this noble sport, the sport of robot kings. Honestly, Max, the height limit alone should have precluded him from season 4, let alone his...
Pilots, please settle down. You're both way off with your guesses. Just wait until our first round. Just wait.
100 customized robot gold.
Great job.
Campaign!
Ah, yes, hello, Mr. Mayor. It's your old pal, Max, here. You remember me, Max, your buddy, CM? I gave you that briefcase a while ago. Well, I need your help. I'm putting on a reunion show for my robot golf entertainment franchise, and I need a city to play in. I was thinking of all the great cities I visited, and I can't stop but think about how great yours was. Of course this isn't a joke. I've definitely kept track of your city on the grow, even after the robot wars.
Now surely you're exaggerating. We're playing golf with 100-foot robots here. Some small water damage isn't going to be a hurdle.
Mayor, I will take no false modesty. We'll be playing golf in your city tomorrow. Just send out the warning notices. And naturally, I expect two of your finest local competitors. And a golfing celebrity. No excuses. Ladies and gentlemen, I lined up our first round of golf. It's time to make golfing television! That's right, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Max, and it's time for the Yes, Let's Drive for Par reunion tour. Our first stop is a dear favorite of mine, Old Bay City. Let's turn it over to the city's special guest.
Hello, I'm the forgotten fourth even older brother, Rory McIlroy. On behalf of the mayor of Old Bay City, I welcome you to this mildly damp golfing wonderland.
While definitely more underwater than I remember, Old Bay City still has that timeless charm and made it known worldwide.
And Camilla steps up to the tee.
That was a good drive.
That ball is off to dreamland. Come to sleep on the fairway.
Building ever do to you, you turd.
Max? I think there's been some kind of terrible mistake here. I'm playing against training robots.
Hey now, you're a golf star. On the fairway, go play.
Ding dong, what a drive. Looks like Davy Jones has added to his golf ball collection. This one has landed directly in that ocean bed.
Miller swings away. Ah, so close you could smell the hole if your robot has some kind of extra smelling power. I'm always of the opinion that a putt comes from the mind and not the heart.
I am being informed by my lawyers that I need to point out that my surname is McElroy with an E. I am not at all related to the famous PGA golfer from the before times. PGA is a registered trademark of the Professional Golfers Association Limited, and this is absolutely not related to their very high-priced lawyers in any way.
Kind of a tight spot there, but she worked her way out of it. You've come within spitting distance of the hole. If you can spit really far, you're pretty far from the hole. Leading off from the fairway, let's see how close we can get it.
It could go all the way. No, it can't. Well, that's one less biodome to worry about.
Not happy, Max.
Camilla sure can golf, huh? Fair way on a fair day. If we still had day and night, we're aiming from the fairway.
Looks like this one's the property of the Little Mermaid. What will she call it? Probably something stupid, like a Gorblax. Down that old sweet tea for another great shot.
Now, Griffin, we're on the green, and I have a question for you. Why don't they call it the red or the blue?
God only knows. Now this one actually literally will be a tough putt. Let's see if they can't close the gap here on the green. That was a wonderful shot from Camilla.
This is the last hole! Nice work by all of the robot golfers that have visited our fair city today. I would really like to go home now.
T for two and two for T. It's time to get started. great golf, Camilla.
For those keeping track at home, the robots are now smashing the only way we sustain life on the moon. The wars have begun, and we are losing.
This is fun.
No, it isn't. I can't believe I'm playing golf at the bottom of the ocean against training robots. How am I meant to show my face at the Robot Country Club after this?
I'm not supposed to pick favorites, but I'm a big fan of Camilla.
That ball is off to dreamland. Come to sleep on the fairway.
Time to use their missiles? Well, no one's quite sure what's going on in their head. We're trying to get from the fairway to the green.
That's far enough, little ball. Far enough. Someone hold her parasol. Camilla's ready to golf.
Nobody cheers for teachers who may do their job, but congratulations on sinking the putt.
Okay. Now, before you say anything, I'll admit that maybe we had a few snags.
Max, I just played a round of robot golf where the headliner was a training robot. A training robot. On top of that, my robot is going to need at least a month's worth of decalping. A few snags is an understatement. I'm out.
Wait. I promise you, this next one is going to be the main show.
Ah, dang. I need to get back to my shop, Max. I've got to prepare for the next celebration.
One more show. It'll be huge. We'll do it on the moon.
Fine. One more show, Max. You've got one more shot.
Hi, honey. It's me. Max, I need your help. Ah, you saw. Well, I mean, sure, I wondered why it was called New Bay City, but I'm a busy man. I can't be expected to follow all the world events. What? Both of them? And I thought he was dead? Wow. Yes, perfect. Max is back, baby.
How can I help you, V?
Get me on the line with whoever's in charge at NGBL these days. Tell them we need Project A and Project C activated and deployed ASAP.
Of course. Would you like me to contact BioPal Labs as well?
No. Suzume needs a soft touch. I'll take care of her. Personally.
Aveline, you're a brilliant robot rocket scientist. It's your aptitude for technology that won us over, even in spite of your young age. But here at Future NASA, you work as part of a team. You have to respect the rules and regulations that come with working at a government facility.
Hang on there a moment. I know I'm a little biased as her boss and mentor, but Aveline has made leaps and strides with her teamwork and communication skills recently.
Let me read you the latest report from our facility's lead. Loud music heard blasting from Aveline's department. All toilets in the JSC ladies' room shattered from an internal explosive force.
Sorry. Administrator, go on.
Grind marks found on the recovered first stage of the Saturn V rocket that brought Apollo 11 to the moon.
Wait, when did you do that?
I didn't. Well, I mean, it was a really good line. I had to.
Nice.
This is exactly what I'm talking about. I'm sorry, Uncle. You're good people, but I can't pull any more strings to keep you two out of trouble. As of now, Aveline, your services are no longer needed at Future NASA.
Look, Aveline is the most brilliant and kind rocket scientist I know, and she's only just getting started. I'm not going to sit here and let Future NASA make the biggest mistake since Skylab Putt-Putt. If Aveline goes, I go too. Huh. That didn't go as well as I expected.
That's dumb.
Hi. Uncle? Aveline? That's you two, right?
Hi. I like your hair.
Thanks. I like your skateboard. I heard you both just got fired. Wait, I'm sorry. I didn't mean for that to sound so cheery. I'm just glad I got here first. I have a deal for you. I work at NGBL. Have you heard of us?
Oh, the robot golf people? Aren't you more, canine-focused these days?
I have a new project I'm heading up while Project C is on the course. It's called Project A.
Nice! That's already two better than Project C! But surely you've already got a full engineering staff. Why us?
No. This is a pilot-linked golfing robot. It needs two human pilots who are in sync with each other. Like you two.
But I've never golfed before in my life!
Dude. This is the same team that just jammed a bunch of dogs into a robot to play golf. I think we can pretty easily play sports better than those puppies.
Is that a yes?
What do you think, Aveline?
I'm in, but I have three requests. One, I want the robot to have a sick skateboard.
I think if we take out the missiles, we can make that work.
Two, no lamos allowed. Everyone has to be cool with whatever music I want to play.
And the third thing?
Project A is a dumb, boring name. If Uncle and I are piloting a robot, it has to have a cool name. Like Putz McKenzie, the Nose Grinder 1080, the Rolfer. See, Rolf means robot golf, and put it together, and it's
How about Liquid Steel?
Yes, oh my god, yes, Liquid Steel, it's perfect.
Okay. I'll see what we can do about renaming it to Liquid Steel. In the meantime, let's get you on the course!
Liquid Steel! Oh, wow! Look how big this board is! I'm gonna grind everything!
This might be a hole-in-one, but it's definitely going to be a hole-in-fun. Let's go. Ooh, daddy-like. It ain't easy being green, but it's real easy playing from the green. Choice shot.
Now it's time for Aveline and Uncle.
That is awesome!
Look at that lazy ball, just stopping wherever it wants.
Abilene and Uncle lining up. That putt was all putt butter and jelly.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Uh-huh.
Looks like we're going to have to stop at the burned out supermarket to get some putt butter for the next shot.
Well, that cup is just hungry for ball food. Let's see if we can't feed him with this putt. That hole's all done full up with putt butter. Great shot.
Grand slam. Griffin, do robots dream? Also, how do you think this next hole is going to go?
No, and great.
Four!
If this were an autobiography of that shot's life story, we'd have reached the conclusion. Stirring ending for that shot.
Now that that building's gone, I can see the sunrise from my apartment.
Looks like that ball never got the message from his mama not to play in the street.
Well, looks like we got ourselves a convoy. We're playing off the street.
This is a great way to earn your bread and putter. Bread and putter? Get it? Putter!
Ugh, I get it. I get it.
Hole's not in there, you goofy little Gus. Watch this. I'm going to stop this ball with my mind. Didn't work. Let's hurry up and get out of this sand. If there's something that's worse for the various gears and components of robots, I cannot imagine.
It could go all the way. No, it can't. Uncle's a fun word to say, huh? Uncle, 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 uncle. Anyways, great shot.
It's time to lay down some of that smooth putt butter. Let's get it in the cup. The green? Well, that's exactly where you want to be. shot was just liquid steel all over.
Just about to come apart in 1999. It hasn't been destroyed.
Hold up, it is. I'm just kidding.
Holy Bergoli, that was amazing!
That was so much fun! I can't imagine what this must be like in a tournament.
Well, you're gonna find out pretty soon. You both did so well that we've organized a company golfing match for you. Ready for a fun round against Project C?
Yeah, let's kick some dog butt!
I'm ready for a hole of a time!
Ugh.
Thinking out loud here, are the creators of golf known as forefathers?